Good evening, students. All the students should have the fine health. All the students are well. Students, आज का आप सबका मेरे विवेक लेक्चर्स में आप सबका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है. जैसा कि आप सब जानते हैं कि कल हमने कुछ मोटिवेशन की बातें की थी. मैं अपने अपनी मैंने आपको मोटिवेशनल स्टोरी सुनाई. आज बिना टाइम वेस्ट किए हुए आज हम फिजिक्स का एक बहुत इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक करेंगे जो बहुत ही इम्पॉर्टेंट है. दिस टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. दिस इज अ चैप्टर 9 ऑफ योर बुक्स इन विच इट विल नेम एज इलेक्ट्रॉनिक डिवाइसेस विच इज ऑल्सो बी सब डिवाइडेड इंटू 3 कैटेगरीज. फर्स्ट इज सॉलिड्स, सेकेंड इज सेमी कंडक्टर डिवाइसेस एंड थर्ड इज गेट्स. At first, we have to be talk about what is solids. You know what is solid? I think, do you know? Why? Because solid is generally thing which is incompressible. Which is incompressible. We should not compress the solids. Should not compress the solids. Generally, wood, other solid items which should not be compressed, like this whiteboard, the walls, etc. All these things which should not be compressed, is it? Solids are generally of two types. You should also study it in chemistry. The first lecture, I think you do know. Is it? So, solid is amorphous and a crystalline. Crystalline solid is what? In which the constituent particles are arranged in a definite order. And amorphous solid is what? In which the constituent particles are not arranged in a definite manner. In amorphous solid, we are generally know that is it's plastic, it's glass, etc., chalk, etc. All these are amorphous. And crystalline is all the metals, their compound are generally crystalline solids. So according to these solids, we have to be study our valence band theory. I shall first do you know about this thing. We take a silicon crystal in which it has atomic number 14. 14 atomic number, then what is the configuration? This is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, then 3s2, 3p2. It means it has 4 valence electrons in which 2 electron in s subshell and 2 electron in p subshell. There are total 4 vacant and 4 fully filled because there are total at n atoms. Why? Because 6 in p and 2 in s. So 4 is filled and 4 is empty. So now we have to be study about these whenever this is an actual atom position. This is called interatomic separation. This is small r. We have to be denote. You also denoted it by small a. It's different book has different legacy to use the different words. So we say when it is in position of D1, there is no any flow of electrons because it is very far from the interatomic separation. From D2, this is a little bending will take place. At D3, it all will be collapsed. No one will doubt that what is S atom, what is P atom. Only one can say that there are 8 actual atoms in which 4 are vacant and 4 are filled. And in actual interatomic separation, the band will be constituent into 2 band. One is valence band, it is empty, it's not full of electrons, and it is a conduction band. Electron generally from conduction band jumps to the valence band and there is a gap in between these which is called forbidden energy gap. According to this, we have categorized metals, non-metals, is it, and semi-metals. The metals in which the energy gap is no energy gap. Either two metals will collapse each other, it is called metal. But those metals which have small energy gap, this is called a semi-metal, means small flow of energy is required to jump the electron from a conduction band to valence band. And also, I think there is a insulator in which the energy gap is very, very large. Is it? Electrons should not to be attained from one state to another. So in this case, no current will take place. We have called it is insulator. In wood, it's a similar takes place. So this is a valence band theory. On the basis of this valence band theory, we have to be take again, there are two type of conductor, which is a p conductor and semiconductor. We have discussed about these semiconductor should tomorrow, and today I have to be study only about you one thing again. Doping is what? Doping is generally a process in which an impurity is added to the pure semi-crystal atom to improve its conductivity. We have added some impurity atom to improve its conductivity, so it's called doping. We shall discuss about these doping criteria tomorrow. So I think you should enjoy the today's lecture. So goodbye, thank you all the students.